of the alternative station, Joe Jewett in the morning show at 7:47 now. Time for now loading our weekly look at this week's big video game releases. That's all brought to you by Comic Town, your source for comic books and more. And Jeremy from Gaming Nexus is in. How you doing, Jeremy?
Oh, not too bad.
What's coming out this week?
Another busy week this week. First off, on the PC, there's a new action RPG called The Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing.
Okay.
Pretty fun game. I did a preview on it a couple weeks ago. But it's kind of much like the popular games like Torchlight and Diablo.
Okay.
Kind of a point and click. You point and telling where to go, click on your enemies to attack. You don't have direct control over him.
Okay.
But it's all about killing hordes of monsters and gathering different loot and equipment and joining up with friends online. Incredibly solid game. It's $14.99, available on Steam.
Okay.
And could possibly be coming to the Xbox Live Arcade later this year.
Okay. What else do we have?
Also, the big, getting rave reviews is Donkey Kong Country Returns 3D for the 3DS.
This is one that's like my kind of game.
Yes. Sounds familiar. Donkey Kong Country was an old SNES game from the mid-90s. They brought the series back a couple years ago on the Wii, mm-hmm. and this is a port of that adventure from the Wii, but enhanced with 3D graphics. Some additional things. They've added some new equipment you can pick up, new tricks he can do, but classic Donkey Kong Country style, old school gaming. You're donkeying Diddy, and you're trying to stop this Tiki tribe from stealing all the bananas from Donkey Kong Island. Mm-hmm. So, classic Nintendo adventure.
Gotta watch out for those Tiki tribes.
Yes. Classic Nintendo adventure, getting rave reviews. They're pretty much saying it's one of the, if not the best games you can get for the 3DS. And just... if you've ever loved games any time in the past 20 years, you will probably love this one.
Before we get into this, last one, I was reading. I actually read an article yesterday that was talking about movie-themed games, which made me think. Like, I get why manufacturers want to do this because you have like it's a known brand. It's a known commodity. You know, the movie studio spends so much money, you know, even if it's like a new movie or something. Like, I don't know if there was a Prometheus game last year. I'm going to guess there probably was because they make a game out of anything. But, you know, the studio spends so much money getting that name out there. And then so it's a little bit easier from a marketing concept for a gaming company. But with rare exception, nobody buys these games. And they're not very good. Like, I think your exceptions are probably like Star Wars. People will run out and buy a Star Wars game. And I don't count something like a Batman or something because that didn't start out like a movie. You're not really taking off on that. But they keep making movie games that, like, nobody will buy. Like, I heard the new Star Trek game, I heard it's not doing very well.
Horrible.
Yeah.
It's just a horrible... And they... I don't know. It's...
It's a good movie, but as a game...
It's a good movie.
People don't care.
Well, I think they get mixed messages in terms of what the two different audiences want to see.
Yeah.
They try too much to deliver the movie experience, which is 2 hours, you're said and done.
Yeah.
That's not what a gamer wants out of a game.
As opposed to, like, just a game that's sort of kind of based on the film.
And you know what? It's the other way, too. It's the video games that get taken and turned into movies.
Yeah.
Haven't done historically well.
That's right.
I mean, they're
yeah.
pretty bad. It's yeah. the same thing, because it's two distinct audiences, and they... You know, the big wigs, the people
yeah.
who are signing these checks and signing this money, want to lump them in the same group, but they want two different experiences.
Yeah.
And, you know, your movie fans, they want the two and a half hours, start to finish, done, that's your experience. Gamers don't want that. We want something you can go back and play again and again, something that makes you feel a part of it. So when they try to transfer the one to the other, they fail to adapt to what they want.
I know. And that said, there's a new Resident Evil video game.
Yes, but this one isn't based on the movies.
Okay.
This is an original, actual Resident Evil adventure.
Okay.
Resident Evil Revelations. Now, this one's kind of a different take. Normally, you hear about companies take their big games and scale them down for a portable market.
Yeah.
To go on Game Boy or DS or whatever. This is just the opposite. This was a portable game released last year for the 3DS that did very well, got rave reviews. They've taken it, enhanced it, and are now releasing it on the consoles.
Okay.
So, typical Resident Evil adventure. This takes place between 4 and 5. High-def graphics, you know, updated graphics, some new features, especially on the Wii U. There's a lot of control features added to take advantage of their tablet controller. And reviews have been pretty positive.
Okay.
And it's also a little cheaper than most games. It's $49.99 versus the traditional $59.99.
Yeah.
And you can pick that up on the Xbox 360, PS3, Wii U, and the PC.
Cool. Before I let you go, there was a lot of talk about new consoles this week.
New Xbox was revealed, the Xbox One.
Yeah.
I don't know. I've got a jaded,
and there it is.
I've got a jaded opinion on it because I personally wasn't sold on it.
Okay. Well, that's fine. Why? Why weren't you?
It just doesn't suit my needs when I'm comparing it to the PS4.
Yeah.
because I was sold on that due to some features it has that.
What's it? What's it lacking? What's the Xbox? What's the new console lacking?
Well, I guess, and it's also part of it was the way they pitched it. The whole presentation this week was on the entertainment aspect of it.
Yeah.
It's meant to be your entertainment hub in your living room. It's basically the equivalent of a souped-up media center PC.
Yeah.
All your different media devices will be routed through it. You can switch between them from the Xbox, and it's meant to make that seamless. I've got a media center PC, so that's not something I need. That's why I wasn't sold on it.
Okay.
But I can completely see how other people
But for
were.
Other people, yeah.
You know, but that's really all they've pitched it for so far is the entertainment aspect of it. In 2 weeks, E3 is when they're going to pitch all the games.
Yeah. That was actually the headline that I saw this week was, hey, they'd like you to throw all this other stuff you own away and just use this box.
Yeah, I mean, it's meant to consolidate a lot of boxes and basically be a hub for them.
I can see where that's appealing to people.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. But,
but not to you.
No, not what I want.
All right, people want more information on the games. Jeremy, where do they go?
GamingNexus.com.
Thank you.
No Repeat Thursday. The Alternative Station, CD 1025.